third-party ActiveX controls can be inserted into ProcessBook just like any other ActiveX control container can accept ActiveX controls. Now, why would you want to do this? Basically because you can find controls out on the open market that are much better than some of the things that we use to display data. I'll give you an example right here. People for years have wanted some kind of a gauge that looked like a real gauge. Now, we do bar graphs, but we don't do gauges. And when people would ask us, when are you guys going to do some gauges, our answer's always been, well, you know, the best thing for us to spend our engineering efforts on is to make ProcessBook an ActiveX control container, so you can go out and get the best gauges in the industry and license them so that you can put them on all your client applications. So here's an example of a gauge that comes from a company called Global Magic. This is a gauge that's being driven by the values that we're seeing right in here. This CDT158 is driving the value, so each time a new value comes in here, that drives this. It's using a pretty simple script, which we'll look at in just a second. Here is the code that's being used to populate the gauge with values from ProcessBook. This is done in the value object in the data update event. So whenever a value gets a new updated snapshot value in ProcessBook, that triggers the script that will go out and use the getValue method to get a value from this value object and put that value into the ActiveX control. This ActiveX control is called car1. If we take a look at what IntelliSense shows us, it's got a whole wealth of different properties and methods available. It's one of the reasons people like using ActiveX controls is because there are so many good ones out there. You can really implement state-of-the-art or best-of-breed applications with just a nominal amount of engineering and expense. Now the question we most often get when discussing ActiveX controls is, how do you put them into ProcessBook? How did we first of all license them, and how did we put them into ProcessBook? Well, I was able to license this by simply downloading a demo version. There's a demo version of this automobile ActiveX control. This one is an executable called Cars. This originally was a gauge that was used in video games for cars, for tachometers, oil pressure, things like that. In any event, I simply found a demonstration copy, an evaluation copy. I installed this like I'd install any other piece of software. And once I've installed that, I can then go in and install it into ProcessBook like any other ActiveX control. I'll click on the control button. I'll click on a space that I'd like to put this. And it now shows up just like any other ActiveX controls on this list of ActiveX controls. There it is, the automobile gauges control. As I said, you can get this from globalmagic.com. There we see the control. Let's get rid of the old one there. Here's the control. Now, like many controls, these controls disappear when you're in design mode. A lot of ActiveX controls work like that.